join in God's great kingdom work. John the Baptist recognized this, and he became a great disciple for Jesus. Notice verse 7, chapter 1, says, he proclaimed, "One more powerful than I am coming after me. I am not worthy to bend down and untie the strap of his sandals." Verse 8, "I baptize you with water, but he shall baptize you with what?
The Holy Spirit."
The Holy Spirit. John was a disciple of Jesus Christ. We are disciples of Jesus Christ. And like John, our mission, our purpose is to point people to Christ. Allow him to wash away their sins and to cleanse them. To have no regrets. In the movie that was made several years ago, Schindler's List, Schindler was a pot maker for the Germans. And he used his pot making factory to save hundreds of Jewish people. But in the last days, as the war was coming to an end, and he was going to try to escape to get to the Allies, he began to weep with regret. He pulled a pen out of his pocket, the pen was gold plated, and he said, "You know, if I had sold this pen, I could have saved two more lives." He looked at his coat and said, "If I had sold this, I could have saved more lives." He looked at his car and said, "If I had sold that, I could have saved even more lives." He had those regrets. We need to be disciples of Jesus Christ with no regrets. That we know we've done all we can with all the resources that God has given to us to share with our family, to share with our friends, to share with our neighbors this amazing God that we serve, who cleanses us of our unrighteousness, who fills that void in our hearts and our lives, who transforms us. We have been redeemed to remove the obstacles, to clear the way, to prepare the way for the Lord. We have a purpose. We're all outcasts. We're all exiles. When Karen gave birth to our child, our first and only child, the question was, what do you name your child? And there are a lot of great names. We chose the name Wendy because it means pilgrim, sojourner. We are all Wendy's, sojourners. We're all pilgrims. This is not our final destination. This is our temporary home. We are brought together. We are transformed into a magnificent band of believers with a purpose of sharing Christ. So I invite you to choose your life and to live your life with no regrets. To know that on the resurrection morning when Jesus comes in the clouds of glory, to know that we have done all we could do for the kingdom of heaven. We have prepared the road. We have been a living poster or a living billboard for Jesus Christ and his kingdom. To show how different we can be when Jesus Christ is our King and our Lord. How we can be that amazing billboard for Jesus Christ. So during the millennium, when we learn who's saved and who's been lost, and even though we'll weep for those who are lost, we'll rejoice because there'll be so many people that will come up to you and say, "Thank you, because of you, I found Jesus Christ." We will be surrounded by people and say, "Thank you for caring enough to share Jesus." So I invite you this week to look for those divine opportunities to share Jesus Christ with your family, with your friends, with your neighbors, with people that are total strangers, and to say, "Let me tell you what Jesus has done for me." I'm willing to do that. Let's stand together, dedicate ourselves to being a living billboard for Jesus Christ this week. To live our lives with no regrets. Father in heaven, Lord, you've done so much for us. But help us not to be content just what you've done for us, but to share with others how you transform our life. Give us the wisdom to see, the words to speak with family, friends, and neighbors, and strangers that you bring to our lives. I pray in Christ's name. Amen.